this woman to be married to this man?
I do.
Frank, would you close those doors for me, please? Would you bow your heads with us as we pray? Father, thank you for this day that you've given to Stephen and Allie. And Father, we just ask that you would smile on them today. This day that they've dreamed of and waited for and anticipated has arrived. And we ask that you just fill this house with your presence, with your love, and may you bless this couple on this new beginning that they are starting today. We ask this in Jesus' name. Amen. The couple has requested, you may be seated, that we begin this ceremony out of the book of 1 Corinthians chapter 13, which is very common and known to all as the love chapter. And let me just read a few of these verses. If I speak in the tongues of men or angels but do not have love, I am only a resounding gong or a clanging cymbal. Love is patient. Love is kind. It does not envy. It does not boast. It is not proud. It does not dishonor others. It is not self-seeking. It is not easily angered. It keeps no record of wrongs. Love does not delight in evil, but rejoices with truth. It always protects, always trusts, always hopes, and always perseveres. Love never fails. Friends, because of the sacredness and great meaning of marriage, I shall take a moment to tell you what the Bible says about it. The rite of marriage in which you two come now to be united is the oldest religious rite in the world. It was instituted by God while man was in his innocency. Man fell, but marriage did not. What it was at the beginning, it is now. Marriage has never fallen. It has been continued by God to soothe the sorrows and comfort the broken estate of man. The Lord said, "It is not good that the man should be alone. I will make a helpmeet for him." Again he said, "They two shall be one." In creation, Adam the man was first formed, then Eve, says the scripture, that the woman might be for the man. Yet man, in being made last of all God's creative works, was set forth as the most excellent of all God's creatures. So Eve, the woman, being made after Adam and out of him, has the honor set upon her as being the glory of man. As the man is the head, she is the crown, a crown to her husband. The man is dust refined, but she is dust doubly refined, or one step further from the earth. But in being created from man or out of him, she was not out of his head to dominate him or to be over him, nor out of his feet to be under him or to be trampled on by him. But out of his side to be equal with him, from under his arm to be protected by him, and near his heart to be loved by him. Into this holy estate you two come now to be united. Stephen, will you have this woman to be your wedded wife?
I do.
To live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony, will you love her, honor and keep her in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only to her so long as you live, so help you God. Allie, will you have this man to be your wedded husband, to live together after God's ordinance in the holy state of matrimony? Will you love him, honor and keep him in sickness and in health, and forsaking all others, keep yourself only to him so long as you live, so help you God? Stephen, if you would repeat after me. I, Stephen.
I, Stephen.
Take thee, Allie.
Thee, Allie.
To be my wedded wife.
Be my wedded wife.
To have and to hold.
To have and to hold.
From this day forward.
From this day forward.
For better.
For better.
For worse.
For worse.
For richer or poorer.
For richer or poorer.
In sickness and in health.
In sickness and in health.
To love and to cherish.
To love and to cherish.
Till death do us part.
Till death do us part.
Allie. Repeat after me. I, Allie, take thee, Stephen, to be my wedded husband, to have and to hold from this day forward, for better, for worse, for richer or poorer, in sickness and in health, to love and to cherish, till death do us part. Stephen, take Allie's hand. Take this ring and place it upon the fourth finger of her left hand. Let this ring be the seal of your mutual love and fidelity and memorial of this sacred service. You will repeat the following after me. With this ring I thee wed. And with all my worldly goods.
With all my worldly goods.
I thee endow.
In
the name of the Father,
in the name of the Father,
and of the Son,
and of the Son,
and of the Holy Ghost,
and of the Holy Ghost.
Okay, Allie, Stephens, place this ring on his fourth finger of his left hand. Repeat the following: with this ring I thee wed, and with all my love and honor, I give to thee. I thee endow. In the name of the Father, and the Son, and the Holy Ghost. Guard well this your bride who now commits herself into your keeping, and strive to live that no words or deeds of yours shall ever cloud her brow with grief or dim her eyes with tears. Allie, it will be your part to strive to retain by your virtues the heart you have won by your graces. And to you both I would say, let not your voices lose the tender tones of affection, nor your eyes forget the tender ray with which they shone in courtship day. And greatest of all, let God be enthroned in your home and in your hearts above all else and at all times. And now, having heard you make these pledges of your affection, taken these vows of fidelity, I do, by the authority invested in me by the laws of the state of California and the International Healing Place Church, do pronounce that you are husband and wife. Stephen, you may kiss your bride. It is my pleasure to introduce to you Mr. and Mrs. Stephen Vasquez.